Hello everyone, welcome to Happy Cooking World. Today's recipe is pasta with chicken balls. So instead of serving the chicken balls and the tomato gravy on plain boiled pasta, I served it on pasta prepared with garlic, olive oil and salt. You can serve it on plain salted boiled pasta. That is also alright. And for the chicken balls, the ingredients are 2 cups minced chicken, and along with that I have made a slurry for which I used 1 egg and 2 tablespoons of breadcrumbs. If the breadcrumbs are fresh homemade, it's better, but I use store-bought. Other than that, I used minced chili, minced fresh chili, around 2 teaspoons. Use it as per your heat tolerance. I have here 1 teaspoon minced garlic, 1 tablespoon of minced parsley, 2.5 tablespoon of onion minced, and I have over there some seasonings prepared with 1/4 teaspoon of mixed Italian herbs and 1/2 teaspoon of oregano, 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper powder. And you can use some other Italian herbs also along with this, like parsley and some dried parsley also, if you want. And for the cheese, I have used 1 tablespoon Parmesan cheese and 1.5 tablespoon of local farmers market cheese. For the cheese, whatever cheese is available, you use it. And I have also used salt. Use salt as per your taste. And I will also require oil for frying the chicken balls. I will use olive oil. You can use vegetable oil also. So next I will start preparing the chicken balls by mixing all the ingredients one by one into the chicken. So to start off, I took the minced chicken. I added all the mixed Italian herbs and black pepper powder and oregano seasoning. I also added the 2 kinds of cheese which I am using. After that, I am adding the finely minced onion, followed by the garlic. Take care that everything is finely minced. Here I have the fresh parsley. And now I am going to add the slurry which I have prepared with egg and breadcrumbs. And after adding it, I will mix everything together. I will also add the slurry, and then I will add the salt and fresh chili. So just add everything one by one into a mixing bowl. This is the salt I'm adding. You add it as per your taste preference. And then after adding all the ingredients, this is the fresh chili. Just mix it. I prefer to use my hand. Just don't overwork, don't overmix, or overmixing can result in turning the chicken balls hard. I have mixed everything together, and I also require an additional 4 tablespoon of breadcrumbs. Now after starting off with 2 tablespoon of breadcrumbs with egg slurry, I added around 4 tablespoon, but you may require little less or little more. Adjust it to prepare the balls. Now I took oil in an iron skillet, and when the oil is heated, I prepared the chicken balls, and you can see I'm frying the chicken balls in the oil. Just fry it in a medium to low heat. If the heat is very high, what will happen? The outside will become crunchy and inside will remain uncooked. So take some time and be patient and fry the chicken balls, turning the chicken balls on one side till all the sides have taken a light brown color. And then after when the chicken balls are fried, you then put it aside on a kitchen tissue to soak the excess oil. And in that same skillet, add little more olive oil, and in the same skillet we will be making the sauce or the gravy. Here I have fried all the chicken balls and I kept it aside. Now to start off, in the same skillet in which I fried the chicken balls, I added little oil, and then to it I added around minced garlic 1/2 teaspoon. to half teaspoon of garlic. When it begins to turn light brown, I will add the minced onion, half cup of minced onion I have added. And I don't want the onion to become brown, I just want it to become light pink or translucent. When the onion have become translucent, I will add 2 cups of chopped tomato, and with the tomato also add salt as per your taste. And I will mix it, and then I will cover and cook till the tomatoes are cooked properly and oil is seeping out. So I will be waiting for that stage until the tomatoes are cooked and melted. I will cover and cook it, but in between I will open the cover, open the lid and check so that it does not get burnt. So you can see the oil is seeping out. When the oil seeps out, at that stage I again added 1 cup of tomato puree, and then I will mix everything together. Along with the tomato puree, I will also add 1/4 teaspoon of paprika and 1/4 teaspoon of garlic powder, and then I will mix it and cover and cook till again and I will wait till the oil seeps out, but in between I will keep on checking. So when the oil has seeped out, I added 1/2 teaspoon of sugar, and then I will mix everything together. And then I added the fried chicken balls, and slowly I will just coat the chicken balls with the tomato gravy, and I will cover and cook the chicken balls on a medium to low flame. Let it simmer in the gravy so that the gravy enters the inside of the chicken balls. This will take some time, cover and cook, but in between please keep on checking. So when the gravy has thickened, if I find the gravy has thickened too much, I add very little water, around 1/4 cup of water. Don't add too much of water at one time. Add water if needed, little at a time. Again, cover and cook and simmer. And when finally done, I will be adding 1 teaspoon of dried basil, 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper powder, and 1/8 teaspoon of garlic powder. Again, adding garlic powder is optional. Instead of adding garlic powder, if you don't have garlic powder, then you can increase the amount of garlic which you added at the beginning of the recipe in the oil. Little bit you can increase to maybe instead of adding 1/2 teaspoon, you can add 1 teaspoon of fresh garlic at the beginning of the recipe. Then it is now prepared. I will just mix the seasonings and the herbs together and rest it cover for a minute or so, and then I will simply serve it on a bed of pasta. I have served it. If you like the recipe, then please share it with your family, friends, leave your comment, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.